you can now get a sneak peek of Elon Musk's All Vision, neural network-based assisted driving system right here on the streets of China. But if you can't, no worries. In this video, I'm going to walk you through all the pros and cons of the system right now. Chongqing. This is the city most car companies choose to test their smart driving systems, because the traffic here is notoriously insane, even by national standards. And today, I've been cruising around all sorts of roads in Chongqing. In this FSD-equipped Model Y Refresh, let's start with the good stuff. I gotta admit, Tesla's latest smart driving system still carries over that super smooth driving style from the North American version, whether it's changing lanes to pass, or reacting to someone suddenly cutting you off. This system has the least amount of jerkiness of any I've ever used. It feels the most like a real human driver. Like, when you drive, you know your subconscious tells you where to look, when to brake, when to anticipate things. But now, look, it's not a sudden stop. It's super smooth, the whole experience. You'll find that it gives pedestrians an extremely high priority. It almost feels like it's constantly reminding you that it always puts safety first. No matter if a pedestrian is currently crossing the street or not, the system will spot them early and make the right call. In a situation like this, someone's jaywalking. It brakes ahead of time. But there's a lot of stuff you can't really quantify, even though it's a machine doing the driving. You could say it feels very unmechanical. But to put a different spin on that, you could also say it's a little bit cheeky. Don't want to go, oh good, it didn't go. We can go. Please enter waiting area. Hey, we can go. It can read that. It can read Chinese characters. No, it probably just learned the pattern. We were supposed to go. All right. I was so worried it would just see the main green light and punch it. Okay, my bad. Just like a real person driving. It has a bit of a let's see what I can get away with attitude. For example, you can feel how lenient it is with speed limits. It can accurately read the speed limit for the current road. But based on the actual traffic flow, it'll choose to downplay that rule and just go with the flow of the cars around it. In other words, I'll go as fast as everyone else is going, unless it's absolutely necessary. The speed limit is just a suggestion. I'm sure that's exactly how most people drive in their day-to-day lives. And avoiding weird obstacles on the side of the road, that's a piece of cake for this thing. There's an emergency situation up ahead. See that? A motorcycle? So what does it do? It subtly changes lanes. Not all the way. See? And then it moves back into its lane. That motorcycle was parked in the bushes on the median. It would be really hard to spot it as an obstacle, but it was definitely encroaching on the lane. That was such a pro driver move. And sitting here in the car, I didn't feel any sharp braking or anything. It was buttery smooth. If you get a chance to try this system, you'll realize it notices a lot of things you normally wouldn't. And if you watch the speedometer closely, you'll see that even when it's dealing with sudden events, it tries its best to make the acceleration and deceleration gentle to ensure the passengers are comfortable. This, in my opinion, is FSD's biggest core strength right now. You're probably thinking, all you do is hype it up. Doesn't it have any flaws? Come on, you know me better than that. Even though a review like this is mostly my subjective feeling, I always try to stay neutral. So next up, I'm going to share some things I hope Tesla can fix before the wide release. First, my main issue from before is still here. When it comes to certain red lights, it'll just barrel right through them. Okay, and it just ran another red light. We're going straight, but the left turn light is red, so we stopped. But we're going straight. I'm going to take over here for a sec. Or, I'll just give it a little gas. Get it going. Okay, and now I'm letting go. This is not a mistake Tesla should be making. At this intersection, the system tried to change into the dedicated right turn lane, but the traffic was just too heavy. I watched it try several times and it failed. Was forced into the straight left turn lane. But when the right turn light turned green, it seemed to forget where it was and started moving with the cars on the right. That's a surefire way to get a ticket. I've seen them in North American FSD reviews. And Tesla usually nails them. I tested it today too, on wider intersections. It can pull it off in one go. No hesitation. But because the Tesla has a larger turning radius, at an intersection like this, it can't make it, so it just throws it in reverse right in the middle of the intersection. But the moves it made after that, man, it was just wasting time. I couldn't watch anymore, so I had to take over. Wow, I can't I'm taking over. This is so embarrassing. Ha ha ha, I should get tinted windows. If running a red light is 6 points on your license, then driving in the wrong lane is probably 2, but changing lanes over a solid line. In my opinion, that's a pretty major bug in the current version. Changing lanes over a solid line. Luckily, the car in front did it too, I think. Yep. He's going for it. He changed lanes over a solid line, but it does it so smoothly, even over a solid line. It makes it feel like a dotted line. Haha. That's the crazy part about it. You can't fix that. Many traffic tickets are issued here. My friend in the passenger seat is dying laughing. Okay, I've laid out the good and the bad, but let me wrap up with a quick summary. First, I still believe that this Tesla system has a really solid foundation. Its fundamental driving skills are commendable, but then it makes boneheaded mistakes like running red lights and crossing solid lines, which makes you think this should not be happening on this system. On one hand, it's a super confident, skilled pro driver. On the other, it's a total amateur who couldn't even pass the written part of the driving test. That's honestly how it feels right now. And the reason for that, I think, is the FSD hasn't been truly localized yet. That's why Tesla hasn't pushed it out to everyone. But if they can fix these lane and traffic light issues before the official release, then I think this system will still be incredibly valuable if you get the chance.